That said, I'm announcing today that I will be running for representative of the 30th District of the state of Texas to fight for our religious liberties and to turn our nation back to the foundational roots that establishes its greatness. May God bless you and may God bless America.
Hey everybody, wave at the nice TV people. Hello! Let, pretend like you're in a ball game. Hello! The camera just came in. Hi, Mom!
Hey, Mark. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've got three vehicles, there's three vehicles across the street over here. If you parked over here in where, Lee? The funeral home. If you parked in the funeral home, don't give them their business when it's time to go to heaven. So you got to move your car, okay?
Hey, somebody in the crowd reminded me of a story that I ran across yesterday and put on my blog. I had to read about it in a Chinese newspaper, English language Chinese newspaper. On the 20th of September, the red Chinese flag will fly over the White House in commemoration of the 60th anniversary of the kind of communist revolution. It's only taken since January to get this far. Isn't that something? We've got to stop that kind of nonsense.
Take our country back, ladies and gentlemen, and send a letter to your representatives and flood the White House that cannot happen.
I'm not a big believer in flag burning, but that's one I'd like to find a book of matches for. Folks, and it's the 20th. The 20th of September, the United States of America will have the red Chinese flag flying over the White House. And I had to read about it in an English language Chinese newspaper. You won't see that in a lot of mainstream media. Let me bring back up on the stage Rivoli Review. Give them a big round of applause.
Thank you very much, Mark. I'm proud to stand up here today and claim I am a Christian woman. Are you folks tired? Corporations. I don't want them bailing out CEOs. If they're going to give a bailout, how many of you all could use one too? All right, let me see your hand then when you hear me sing, I need a bailout.
Another one of our YouTube videos.
I need a bailout. Won't you help me? Won't you please? I need a bailout. Somebody rescue me. I need someone to save me from bad choices I have made. I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? Well, I spend way too much money cause my bank told me I could. And I refuse to live within the means I know I should. The fact I can't afford it doesn't slow me down one bit. I get instant gratification when I say, hey, just charge it. I need a bailout. Won't you help me? Won't you please? I need a bailout. Somebody rescue me. I need someone to save me from bad choices I have made. I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? Well, my car's got way more gadgets than a person really needs. And my house has got more bedrooms, hey, there's some I've never seen. I knew I couldn't pay it when they gave me that their loan. But they said,
here in America, you deserve to own a home.
I need a bailout. Won't you help me? Won't you please? I need a bailout. Somebody rescue me. I need someone to save me from bad choices I have made. I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? These tennis shoes I'm wearing cost $200 a pair. And it costs $200 to put color in my hair. But you keep paying taxes and I will be okay. Cause the government will bail me out like they did for Fannie Mae. won't you help me, won't you please? I need a bailout. Somebody rescue me. I need someone to save me from bad choices I have made. I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? I need a bailout. Won't you help me, won't you please? I need a bailout. Somebody rescue me. I need someone to save me from bad choices I have made. I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? I need a handout and a bailout. Won't you help me out today? I need a bailout.
Thank you, everybody.
Gentlemen, again, they're going to be on the Mike Huckabee Show on September 19th, so make sure you watch them. You can get their CDs over at the tent. You know, I think another thing that's wrong with our government is that we do not have enough Christian women in leadership. Today with me, here with me today, I have a couple, William and Selena Owens, who are going to speak about their books and Christian women in leadership.
Thank you, Deborah. Welcome. We welcome you here to our Tea Party Rally. We are so excited. We've been traveling all the way from Sacramento. We're going all the way to D.C. with this message today. How many powerful conservative women are in the audience today?
Whoa. I can't hear you.
My husband has a few reasons why you're so powerful.
Let me tell you something. You all know how to spend our money, number one. You have our children, and we thank you for that, number two. And you all are passionate about America. I want to say, hello, Texas! Let me tell you something. We, for too long, have taken for granted the influence that we have. And my wife is going to share with you in a few minutes the influence you have as a powerful conservative woman. As you see these people get up here and educate us about the issues, when this tea party is over, you're going to have to do something with that information. Selena, give him some information. I've been married to this woman for 24 years.
Thank you. My husband and I are authors and publishers, and when we saw what was happening, even prior to the election, just the way America was going, just all that was going on, we decided to use our gift, our talents, and our business, we are capitalists, to make this message known. Now, conservatism has been kind of under the radar as far as women is concerned until one pretty lady from Alaska came along. Mrs. Palin shook things up for us. Now, she's free and doing what she loves to do and wants to do, and she's empowering us, but she needs our help, and we need to give her help. The message that I wrote is called The Power Within a Conservative Woman, Engaging America for God, Family, and Country. Yes! Now, at the end of the day, that's all there ever is. God, family, and country. Those are the values and morals that have gotten us where we're at, that saw us here, and that will prevail. Just like the gentleman said, you have to have three things. You have to have Christianity, you have to have conservatism, you have to have the Constitution. My book stems from a Christian premise. It will tell you about the power of God within you to help circumvent this and how to engage. We cannot just conserve what we know. We must give out and we must engage it at every level of society. Thank you. Woo!
How many Ronald Reagan fans do we have out there? We published a book called Why the Conservative Mind Matters, and is committed and dedicated to Ronald Reagan. We have some back there. This is a commercial break. These buses are able to roll by your contribution. You all see that green tent right there? That green tent right there has the CDs, bumper stickers, our books, and other literature. We need you to be sure you make yourself over there and contribute and make this possible. Thank you. Commercial break is over. Listen, this is our turn to engage. It's our opportunity. Our founding fathers did it. Now it's our turn to be diligent. It's our turn to be vigilant. And we're going to do just that. I want to talk to you about a very, very...